If you want to build a 3D printer from scratch, the control board is one of the most important parts to pick out. Recore is a 3D printer control board that fits perfectly with Klipper. So if you want to spend your time configuring and not compiling, then Klipper is a great choice. We're now up to revision A8 of the Recore hardware, so that is what I'll be using in this tutorial. The board arrives in a package like this, and it comes with software pre-installed. It's a good idea to power up the board using the USB-C connector to make sure that it boots as expected. This LED in the center means power is okay. This LED is CPU activity, here's the eMMC activity, and here is the heartbeat LED. After a few seconds, the board is booted and we can try to get in touch with it somehow. The software has been designed so that it should be possible to do everything you need via a browser, but we're not quite there yet. More on that later. The easiest way to use this is to connect it to the local Ethernet. The device should be accessible as recore.local. Now, let's try the same with a Wi-Fi dongle. With Wi-Fi, the board comes up as an access point, but we need to connect to it from a computer or a phone. If you have Wi-Fi on your laptop, you will lose access to the internet since you are connecting directly to Recore. We see that it shows up and can connect to it. Now let's connect the power supply to the high power input port. We see that one connector is marked VIN and has the positive and negative terminals marked. For currents below 15 amps, it's enough to connect only two of the four wires. The maximum voltage is 24 volts for this board. Let's also connect the stepper motor and an end-stop switch and see if we can do a homing routine. I've got my stepper motor here, a NEMA 17 that can handle up to 2.8 amps, but the connectors are not right. On one side it's JST-PH, on the other it's JST-XH. Luckily I ordered the connector kit, so I can change that side of the connector so it fits. I've also got a micro switch here to use as an end-stop. I'll make a connector for that too. Now I can connect the motor on stepper 0 and the end stop on ES5. I'll add a plunger here too so the motor can hit the end stop. Then I go into Fluid and I configure Klipper so it matches this setup. The default configuration file already has the motor set up right, but I want to use a different end stop connector for this. So I change the setup to match what I have. Now I can try to home the X axis and it looks like that worked. You can also try to set the temperature, but without a heater and thermistor, that will fail after a few seconds. We see that the output is enabled and then Klipper reports an error. Let's go back to that Wi-Fi again, because now I want internet back on my laptop, so I want to connect both of these to my Wi-Fi router. I can get access to this board via SSH and use NMT UI to connect to my router. But as soon as I disable the access point on this, I will get kicked out. So I have to either connect the Ethernet back or I can get a terminal using the USB-C connector. Let me try the latter. Linux users, I may be familiar with the terminal, but you Windows users, not so much. For Windows, you can use PuTTY. For Linux, you can use Minicom. So I connect the USB cable to my host and I see that it shows up there. Looking at DMESC, I see that the serial port is available as /dev/ttyacm0. So I run the command blop. First time I log in, I need to change the password. Now I can run the network manager terminal user interface. First I delete the access point and then I run a scan for local external APs. I see that my AP is here and I can connect to that. I can verify that everything is working by first checking that I have an IP and secondly connect to that via a browser. And there we have it, we're all set up. Recore is now available in the web shop on iagent.no. And from there, you will also find links to other distributors. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.